Welcome to Decoding Studio once again, and today's topic is TypeScript. In this video, we are going to discuss what is TypeScript, why we need this, and how we can install TypeScript inside our React.js and React Native application. And in the last, we are going to discuss what are the benefits using TypeScript in React.js and React Native mobile application. So before moving forward, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please hit the subscribe button now and let's get started. Let's try to understand what is TypeScript first. So TypeScript is just another language which extends JavaScript, and it's provided a type definition. In JS, we don't have any type definition. TypeScript is like a flow, and React Native is built in flow. So it supports both TypeScript and flow. You can use one of them. Okay, so that's all about TypeScript. And now we will see how we can install TypeScript inside a React Native project, because I'm using React Native, but inside of React.js is also the same. So for that, we have this documentation of React Native, official documentation, and here they have tell us like how we can use that. So we are going to use this doc. So first of all, we just need to create an app. We have already created an app. Okay, so here you can see adding TypeScript to an existing project. So first of all, we just need to add a bunch of packages in order to use TypeScript. So I'm going to copy it. I'll provide this doc link in this description as well. Okay, so you just need to copy it from here and then go to your terminal, paste these packages and install these packages here. It will take time, so let's move to another part. Then add a TypeScript config file. So create a tsconfig.json in the root of your project. So copy this and create one more file here inside your root. So root is here, then create new file and paste, and now our type tsconfig.json file is ready here. And just copy these line of code and paste it here. Now we have successfully added tsconfig.json file, so you can see some configuration from here as well. And now we are going to add jest.config.js. So basically, Jest is used for testing, and I have already created a video on TDD, test driven development, where I have explained why we need Jest and other things. So I'll provide a link here so you can check it out from here. So in case you are writing unit test cases or TDD, then you need to create a jest.config.js file as well. So I'm just going to create one. Here you just need to paste this line of code, and that's it. So now you just need to rename a JavaScript file to .tsx. So I have created a example here. So let me close these files, and you can see one profile and second one is smurf details. So inside profile, I'm using a smurf details component that I have created here. And you can see inside smurf, I'm passing one prop name and second one is smurf count. So I'm fetching that props from here and displaying that name here. And then I'm passing smurf count here and displaying the count of smurf. So this is I have created one component. And now let's try to understand why we need TypeScript. So for example, you are expecting smurf count here, a number, and I'm passing a number here, but I can change it to the string as well here. And here I'm passing this string to this display smurf count function, and it will multiply this count here, but it will give an error. And JavaScript is not showing us any error, but once we'll test it in our real production build, then it will give an error. So to overcome this limitation, so we will define a type. So we can use a TypeScript to define a type of variables or props. So let's see how we can do that. First of all, we just need to change the extension or JS from TSX and here as well. Now you can see we have to provide a type here in name and smurf count. otherwise it's showing us an error, like warning, like we need to provide a type, because we are using a TSX file, so it's showing an error and we need to provide a type of these props and this count parameter as well. So as you can see, now in order to provide a type using TypeScript, so we need to add interface here, export interface props, and first is name. So name is string, because we are passing a string, and smurf count will be a number. Now we need to add here react.fc, and just need to pass that interface, props interface that we have created. Now you can see it's not showing an error, because we have provided like smurf count is number. Okay, so that's the benefit of using TypeScript. Same here, if you are using any function and you are passing any parameter into that function, you need to define the type of that parameter. So here count is a number, so it's not showing any error. So that's all about TypeScript, how we can install and what are the benefits of having a TypeScript in our code. So this is the basic example. Just leave a comment and let me know, should we need to use TypeScript in our code or not. And thank you very much. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please hit the subscribe button.